Hi everybody, I am Sean Norman.
I'm Rebecca.
And you're who?
They would like a good morning training for the school with the children.
Do you like dancing?
Yes.
Yes. We start with very easy exercises. We show them. Am I right, my darling?
Yes,
my
darling.
Like damn, he fly. I pimp to the beat, walking down the street in my new freak. Yeah, this is how I roll. Animal print pants out control. It's Red Bull with the big ass bra, and like Bruce Lee, I got the clout. Yeah.
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
I work out.
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
I work out. When I walk in the spot, this is what I see. Everybody stops and is staring at me. I got passion in my pants and I ain't afraid to show it. Show it, show it, show it.
I'm sexy and I know it. I'm sexy and I know it.
Yeah, when I'm at the mall, security just can't fight them all. And when I'm at the beach, I'm in a speedo trying to tan my cheeks. This is how I roll. Come on, ladies, it's time to go. We headed to the bar, baby, don't be nervous. No shoes, no shirt, and I still get service. Watch.
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
Math problems. You are unable to do the homework. You are lost among the numbers. Don't worry. The help is coming. Intelligent washing powder.
Thank you, intelligent washing powder.
Welcome to RTL News Tonight. We are Nicolette Erős
and Tamás Szerbe.
The chemistry class in Dominic Secondary School exploded during an experiment.
Welcome everyone, here I am standing in the middle of rubble and piles of injured students. You can see that incredible conditions prevail in the class. The explosion caused an enormous mess. As you can see, many students are injured, but the ambulance have started to treat them. And now over to Esther Bodoc, who is going to make an interview with the class's chemistry teacher.
Welcome everybody. Next to me is the chemistry teacher who was present at the explosion. Welcome to you. What was the main cause of the explosion?
I really don't know, actually. I can't remember anything. It seems to me that I just wanted a big fuss. I wanted to show to my students that chemistry was a very, very exciting subject. I would like chemistry to be more popular so much would like.
What kinds of materials did you use during the experiment?
As I said, I can't remember anything. I put some this and that into the test tubes and I heated them and I waited something special to happen. And finally there were flames and smokes and foams. Well, it was really exciting actually.
Was there a similar case in the past?
Oh no, nothing similar has happened so far. Actually, I have had enough that my students always expect an explosion while I show to them an experiment, and now there has been a real explosion.
And how many people or students have been injured?
Maybe there are some injured students in the classroom, but actually I don't care so much. They shouldn't have entered the chemistry lab, and actually, you know, going to school, especially to the chemistry classes, is a dangerous habit, isn't it?
Are there any harmful material in the air?
Perhaps there were some unexpected reaction, and actually I can smell something special in the air, but to tell the truth, I like it. I like it very much.
How could we prevent accidents like this? Or what are the most important points that we have to concentrate on?
If you don't do anything, nothing special will happen. That's it. And maybe you should try to avoid the explosions, because it can cause an amnesia to you.
Thank you for the interview.
You're welcome.
You could hear an interview, and I was established.
Thank you, Esther.
A crazy monkey escaped from the zoo.
A mad monkey disappeared from his cave and ran to the school on Wednesday morning. In the building, he behaved like a bad student. He stole all the markers in the school and kicked up a lot of running students in the corridor. According to the recordings of the security cameras, he went to the girls' locker room while the girls of 10C were preparing for the PE lesson. In the fifth period, the police of the school caught him with a professional trap and arrested him.
Boys' toilet at the orange.
Six students were caught using drugs in the boys' toilet. After fighting smokers hard for the past years, the school management at DEG now faces a new challenge: drug abuse. It seems students are very inventive in creating newer and newer drugs. Rotting pencils filled with narcotics is the latest craze. To the students' alarm, the head of the school drug commando yesterday appeared in the toilet opposite classrooms, one per A and one per B, which popular with smokers too, and captured the misbehaving students. They've been taken to the director's office for a good lecture.
Irresponsible use. Aren't they aware that such acts have to be reported to the police? This serious problem needs to be taken much more seriously, and serious decisions need to be made. I plan to invite the whole group to a drug prevention training.
Well, we have already talked about it a lot. I saw the boys from 10C when doing it at least three times. I'm still astonished by this embarrassing situation. It's unbelievable what youngsters try and enjoy nowadays.
It's a very serious offense. If not only illegal, but clearly breaches the rules in our code of conduct. We reported the case to the police, and I assure you we won't tolerate such behavior at our school. Their punishment will be as grave as their crime, because these students are first-time offenders, they will not be imprisoned. But the school will severely punish them. Together with the heavy smokers we catch, they have to clean the toilets for a week.
It is clearly an addiction and a way of escaping for these children. If they were at happy school, they would not, never, never turn to smoking, alcohol or drugs. It is our responsibility to help and not to punish them. The teachers and the school management must make an effort to improve the conditions for them. For them, you all. Let me make some suggestions. The school should start later to assure a good night's sleep for students. That's the first point. Teachers shouldn't patrol corridors. Students feel like in a prison. The teachers are constantly nagging students with tests and presentations. It's very harmful. Students at DEG need new facilities: a swimming pool, a cinema, a wellness center with a jacuzzi, and a Thai massage, an amusement arcade, and a fast food restaurant. I say, no stress, no drug problems.
You have seen RTL News tonight, and thanks for attention.
Have a good night.
Goodbye.
Can you mention a more beautiful Christmas present than an iDesk? the smartphone can help you in the garden. This smartphone can help you with cleaning. This smartphone can help with cooking as well. Surprise your family with this multifunctional device. The latest Apple product guarantees to bring the family together. And now, at the Christmas sales, you can buy it with a 10% discount if you trade in your old device.
We decided to say goodbye. You even had tears in your eyes, but you're running back to me in a romantic movie. Can't escape from this. Girl, you know I'm right. Let me hold you tight. Make it happen tonight. Oh, don't ever say that to me. Love has passed away. Say that to fade. You just want to stay. Take me back, oh baby. Take me back. Don't ever say that to fade. Love has passed away. Say that to fade. You just want to stay. Take me back, oh baby. Take me back. Don't ever say that to fade. Say that.
When I'm with you, my dreams are coming true. When I'm far from you, it makes me blue. But if I try to get close to you, don't...